am Chacharin Leerjotbadin. Today I will talking about the conceptual framework of Python language content modules in robot programming education. The objective of my research is to design a conceptual framework of Python language content modules in robot programming education. I have the procedure 3 steps. 1. I review literature. 2. Setting the conceptual framework. And last one, we evaluating the validity of conceptual framework. The literature review, I take it to the 2 parts. Part 1 about Python programming, and part 2 is robot programming procedure. The synthesis of Python language content is under the table. We can separate the Python language in 3 modules. So the synthesis of the robot programming procedure, we can summarize that have the 5 steps of robot programming. Follow the table. So the result of my research, I can conclude that the Python content module have 4 modules. The module 1 about the basic content of Python language. The module 2 is content for creating the robot software. And module 3 about the robot programming procedure. And module 4 is content of program connection with hardware. So after I have the conceptual framework, I bring it to meet with expert 5 people, follow this table. The result of validity assessment by 5 experts are accepted. So in conclusion, the internal elements of conceptual framework combine the basic of computer language with the programming process, which make it useful for upskill training for beginners. This research is just the beginning to create a guideline for the introduction of Python language content into educational research. And the last one, conclusion, the next step should be to bring the framework to examine its structural validity and content validity with experts in order to build the credibility of the framework. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir, for your presentation. Thank you.